जब हिजाबे पर्दा गैबत उठाया जाएगा, एक दिन वो आएगा।
He is an entrepreneur and corporate trainer with over 27 years of rich experience in marketing and in training executives. Before he established his own setup, he was posted as the Area Training Manager, Western India, Aviva Life Insurance for more than a decade. And in that position, he was directly responsible for training the executives and bankers from the states of Gujarat, Maharashtra and Goa. He loves playing football and reading books. His topic for today, My Journey Towards the 12th Imam. Please welcome Janab Mubarak Sheikh Sahab, who will speak in English.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم I would like to thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى and Ahle Bayt al-Masalam for giving me this opportunity to talk on the subject My Journey Towards Imam Mahdi alayhi salam. I was born as from the Sunni family and I had a very humble I come from a very humble background. I used to live in Vikhroli East in the semi-slums of Mumbai. My mom as always have been a great social worker, helping lot of people, neighbors, friends, family members, and any people who come for any such kind of needs. That is where I met my brother, my mentor, brother Sayyid Abid Hussain. I used to love his company for very simple reason, because he used to always teach me about the story. He used to teach me about the stories of the prophets. He used to say, how do we serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He used to always say that we should have best of the akhlaqiyat. But two things which I remember, very, very important thing which he said in my life, which is a game changer for me. He said, always remember that hidayat is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in times of difficulties you should remember Imam Zamana Islam is Imam Mahdi alayhi salam. Now we moved from Vikhroli East to Vikhroli West for better lifestyle, and my interaction with brother Abid Hussain got very limited. That is where a very unfortunate incident happened with in my family. My sister, who used to stay in Delhi, met with an accident and she got burned to an extent of 65%. Now 65% in medical terminology means near death. The chances of survival is very low. We got the information, we rushed my mom to Delhi by the first flight possible. She went there to the hospital, and on seeing her state, she was very devastated. She came out of the hospital, she called me up and said, Mubarak, her state is not good. I don't think she is going to survive. And she was crying continuously. So that is where I remember the words of brother Abid Hussain, who told me, always remember Imam Mahdi alayhi salam in times of difficulties. What I did is, we all prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and prayed to Imam for help. And while my mom was crying at there, one gentleman came in, one masiya came in to her, asked my mom as to why she's crying so much. She narrated the incident saying that, she narrated the incident that her daughter is not well in the hospital, she's got burned. He suggested that please you move her from this government hospital to a private hospital. Now with limited resources, with limited help, my mom could actually move her in Delhi from a government hospital to a private hospital. In the meanwhile, while she was there in the hospital, my brother Abid Hussain, my mentor, he came all the way to Delhi from Mumbai. He stayed there for a week. He prayed for her and also suggested us that you pray, you recite Ziyarat Yasin, you recite Surah Yasin regularly, and also various forms of Ziyarat. Now we started doing that, and fortunately my sister survived the scare and she's alive today. But after a couple of months, another very unfortunate event happens in our life. My brother Abid Hussain, who was my mentor, got seriously ill. He was hospitalized, and while I was there with him in the hospital on the last day, where we were trying to, you know, get him all right, I was rubbing his chest. His brother was there on his legs, rubbing his legs, but unfortunately he expired. And that is where I got the shock of my life, saying that life is uncertain. One case where my sister was supposed to die, survived, and never in the wildest of the dream we would have thought that she would survive. But my brother will die. Unfortunately expired. That is where I got the shock of my life. I thought, who's that Imam which always brother Abid Hussain used to tell me? And he used to always say that as a reformer known as Imam Mehdi alayhi salam. So I started I got very curious in understanding who is this Imam Mehdi alayhi salam. And he used to always say there is a concept of a reformer. So I thought to myself, what is the concept of a reformer? Is the concept of a reformer only in Muslim religion, or it is there universally? What I could find is the concept of a reformer is not only there in Muslim religion, but it is there in all the religions of the world. Most of the religion of the world is waiting for a reformer. Some call him as Kalki, some are waiting for Krishna, some are waiting for Avatar, and the Christians are waiting for Christ. So I thought, let me see on my books, what is there in my books. So I continued my journey on doing more research on the subject, only to find one ayat from the Quran which says, on the day we shall call every people with their Imam, Surah Isra Bani Israel, ayat number 71. Now I got more excited and more curious on understanding who is this Imam with whom I am going to get raised. With no idea, I started my research doing more and more of studying. And that is where I chanced upon a hadith from the Ahle Sunnah books saying, from the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying, I am leaving behind two weighty things. One is the book which is the Holy Quran, and the other is the Ahle Bayt. Now another concept of Ahle Bayt, which nobody was talking to us in our circle, in the Sunni circles. Nobody was talking about it. So I thought, what to do now? So then I started my journey on understanding who is this Ahle Bayt, whether this Ahle Bayt, who are this Ahle Bayt. And then I chanced upon another hadith, I chanced upon knowing that this Ahle Bayt are basically the Panjatan Paach at that point of time. So who the Panjatan Paach? The Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is number one. So I continued my studying and understanding that if somebody who does not believe in the Ahle Bayt, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then he is not a Muslim. Number two from the Ahle Bayt is Imam Ali alayhi salam. Now the fazilat of Imam Ali alayhi salam is such high that there is a hadith from the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam saying that I am the city of knowledge and Ali is his door. So if somebody has to enter into city, he has to enter through the door. The second fazilat which I could find about Imam Ali alayhi salam was that Imam Ali alayhi salam is the only one person on this earth who is born in the Holy Kaaba. Third, I chance upon, and this is all from, I'm giving references from all the Ahle Sunnah books only. Number three, what I could find is then there is a mention of Imam Hussain alayhi salam, Imam Hassan alayhi salam. Now they are the chief of Jannah. Then I chanced upon another hadith saying that the chief of Bi Fatima Salamullah Alayh is the chief of Jannah for the ladies. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them such high lofty status to the Ahle Bayt alayhi salam. So now what do? Do I take my knowledge from the Ahle Bayt alayhi salam, or do I take my knowledge from someone else? Now, very one pertinent question which came to my mind regularly is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran, Holy Quran, it is mentioned that you will be raised with your Imam, then who was the Imam of Bibi Fatima salamullah alayha? And this I couldn't get an answer from anyone, although the answer was very clear, still there was no answer. Then I said, let me see, while my mind agreed to thinking that the Ahl-e-Bayt are the righteous people, but my heart did not agree, to be very honest. So I said, let me see whether there is a concept of Imam Mahdi alayhi salam, is it there in the Ahl-e-Sunnah books? And only to find, there were several hadiths which I can quote from the Ahl-e-Sunnah books which I could find. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this world will not come to an end till an Arab from my progeny will rule over it, his name will be my name. The hadith is mentioned in Sahih Tirmizi, volume 2, page 46. Number second hadith, very important hadith. After me, there will be 12 khalifs and all will be from Quraysh. This is mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, Tirmizi, Sunan Ibn Dawud and Sahih Muslim. Number three, now this is very, very important hadith. Very, very important hadith. The hadith which says that Mahdi will be a descendant of Fatima salamullah alayhi. Number fourth hadith which I could find, and this hadith summarizes everything what I have spoken about. It summarizes one who denies the reappearance of Mahdi is an unbeliever, he's a kafir. I was shocked to see this hadith and then I started again, I continued my journey on understanding more and more on the subject and got a lot of questions probably which was never answered. Well, number one, on my journey, when in the Holy Quran, it is mentioned that I make the caliph, and when you said to the angels, I am going to place in earth a caliph. This is in Surah Baqarah, ayat number 30. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I am going to make a caliph on this earth, then who has the right to make a caliph other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There's no one. Who could make this, right? And as a process, as we call in the corporate language, the standard operating procedures, you know, standard operating procedures generally followed everywhere. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also follows the same standard operating procedures. So when he has made the caliph from Adam alayhi salam, he has made the caliph as Adam alayhi salam. First he has sent always Hidayat and then the people. And this, and time and again, he has always one prophet after another prophet, one prophet after another prophet, one prophet after another prophet, have always appointed their successor. So do you think that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam will not make a hadi, and Allah ta'ala will leave us without Hidayat? That is impossible. Secondly, the second question which I would like to say is the importance of will. The importance of will. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, Holy Quran, says that making will is important. So would Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a will, or he wouldn't have made a will? And if he has made a will, then what is his will? And why is people not talking, discussing about it? So it is very evident that is a will where he has categorically mentioned that the first Imam after me would be Imam Ali alayhi salam, and the last Imam will be Imam Mahdi alayhi salam. Number three, I am running out of time. Number three, basically is, finally, where do we take our knowledge from? Do we take our knowledge from Ahl-e-Bayt alayhi salam, or do we take from somebody else? Very simple, I would like to quote a very simple example and close on this. If there is a doctor, for example, if my son is not keeping well, and there are two doctors, one is basically an MD, and other basically is a compounder, for example. Where would I take my doctor? And if I have all the money in the world, where would I take medicine from? The answer is very simple. I would take the medicine from the MD doctor only, if I have the money in the world. So this is what I want to share my story on this. I would like to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the blessings and the ma'rifat of Imam Zaman alayhi salam, and also pray that all believing men and believing women get the ma'rifat Imam Zaman alayhi salam. Without prejudice, if one person has to search for the Imam, for the Imam, without prejudice, if you search for the Imam, I am sure, as I have found my Imam as Imam Mehdi alayhi salam, he will also find his Imam as the same Imam as Imam Mehdi alayhi salam. Thank you very much.
On behalf of 12 Talks and the Promised Mehdi, we would like to honor you with a small token of our appreciation. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Thank you, Janab Mubarak Sheikh Sahab, for taking us through your journey. Summarizing his speech, he said that he was born in a Sunni household and who converted later. Spoke about how he got hidayat, how he turned to Imam Mehdi alayhi salam in times of difficulty, which helped to strengthen his faith. We appreciate your sharing this journey with us.
Sadaqallahul Aliyyul Azim.